Welcome back to Imaginarium Animal Spotlight. My name is Carrsan. I am the outreach coordinator here at the Grout Museum District. And today I am bringing you Pepto the Pine Snake. Now, Pepto is very special for a number of reasons. Firstly, she is one of our oldest snakes. She's about 25 years old, around the same age as Rosie, the rosy boa, who we looked at a couple years ago. But pine snakes actually have a shorter lifespan than rosy boas. So in snake terms, she's actually even older than Rosie. She has been alive for a long, long time, longer than her average lifespan, but she's still very healthy. She still eats and sheds regularly, so she is still a functioning, growing snake. And she is actually retired, so we don't really use her for demos anymore. I've only ever used her twice, I think, because I had a snake that was shedding. So she spends most of her time in our offices, just kind of hanging out in her enclosure and sleeping and burrowing in her substrate. So she has a pretty relaxed life, and as you can see, she really likes trying to climb up on my shoulder. But because of that, most people don't really get to meet Pepto, so I thought it would be cool to put her on video so that all of you can get to know a little bit more about this amazing snake. So let's talk a bit about pine snakes. Pine snakes are actually one of the longest types of snakes we have here naturally in North America. They can get to be about 6 feet long. Now, it's a little deceiving because she doesn't look that big around. She's very thin, but she's quite long. Look at how much of her is still wrapped around my hand and also kind of extending her way up my sleeve. She is actually a pretty lengthy snake, so they can get to be about 6 feet long. They have a very wide geographical range where they can live. Pine snakes can live all the way from New Jersey all the way down to Florida and everywhere in between. So they are very versatile in their habitats. They really, really like living in forests with loose soil. The reason for that is that they are amazing burrowers. In fact, they are the most effective burrowing snake in North America. And there's a really cool reason for that. They have four prefrontal scales. Now, prefrontal scales are the scales right in front of a snake's eyes. She has four of them, and I'll show them to you in close-up right now. She has four prefrontal scales. Most snakes in North America have two. Now, those four prefrontal scales kind of determine the shape of her head. As you can see, she has this very pointed, kind of shovel-shaped head that she uses for digging her burrows. They've also been referred to as snakes with a turtle-like head. Personally, I don't think their heads look super turtle-like, but some people say that they do. So if you see a turtle head when you look at Pepto's face, fair enough. I don't see it, but I could be wrong. So they use those specially shaped heads to burrow. And in fact, even in her enclosure, she doesn't have, you know, super deep substrate, but she really, really likes to use that little face to shove her substrate around and dig little burrows. They spend most of their lives in the wild underground. They spend most of their time in burrows. In fact, they will hibernate under the ground from about November until March or April when they wake up in the springtime, because like all other snakes, they're cold-blooded. That means that they cannot regulate their body temperature. They have to slow down their metabolism in cold weather. They do it completely by hibernating in the winter. They can also enter a kind of half hibernation, but that's less common. So they will burrow under the ground and hibernate or sleep throughout the entire winter, and then they'll wake up in the summer through the fall to do whatever it is that snakes do with their free time. So she is carnivorous, just like all the other snakes we've talked about. Even though she is a very, very long snake at about 6 feet or less, she is not a particularly wide, girthy snake. As you can see, her head is pretty small. So they still hunt very small prey, even for their particularly long size. She would eat lots of mice or other small rodents. So because they eat smaller prey, they can eat a lot. For instance, every 2 weeks when we feed our snakes, she will eat four mice. So they can eat a lot of food, even though they are very, very thin, because they need quite a bit of energy to keep that very long, stringy body going. Now, this is not the natural coloration of a pine snake. Typically in the wild, they would range in color from yellow to brown. They'd be a much more natural color. Pepto, in her old age, has gotten kind of white with this kind of dusty pinkish-brown color on her back. I did not get the chance to meet Pepto when she was younger, but apparently she is named Pepto because in a young age, she was actually more pink in color, so people thought she looked like Pepto-Bismol. hence her name, Pepto. As she's gotten older, her scales have dulled a little bit into this white color, but it's not a natural coloration. It is a morph that is created in captivity. Now, we've talked a little bit about morphs in the past, but the morph of a snake or a reptile just means their color. So, for instance, corn snakes, who we'll talk about very soon, have a lot of different morphs. Ball pythons have a lot of different morphs. This is one particular morph for a pine snake, this kind of whitish pinkish color. They're also very, very hardy snakes. Like I said, they have a pretty wide range of habitats, so they have to be able to adapt to a lot of different environments. They have these really heavy plated scales that you can see on their back. So they have pretty strong natural armor, and they can use their size to defend themselves pretty well. So they do not have to worry about a lot of natural predators. Also, the fact that they spend most of their lives under the ground makes it pretty difficult for predators to get to them. They are a snake that is considered threatened in certain habitats, not throughout their entire habitat, but in certain states they are considered threatened, mostly because of deforestation. Because they really need that loose soiled forest habitat to live, unfortunately in areas with a lot of logging or where a lot of forests are being cut down, it makes it difficult for these guys to find a home because they need a very specific kind of environment to live. So that is pretty much all that I have to say about Pepto. She's a really, really interesting snake, especially because of her special burrowing tendencies and also being one of the longest species of snakes that we have here in the United States. I'll be back again next week with another amazing animal spotlight video. If you guys have any specific animals that you would really like to see that I haven't shown yet or any other ideas for the show, please don't hesitate to let me know. I'm always curious to know what you guys want to see. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day.